Hello guys, welcome back to my vlog. Today, I'm talking about the topic of Lynas in this vlog. Let's go! Welcome to the late show of Yafong. Today's topic will be a very interesting one. We are talking about Lynas in Malaysia. This has been an old topic as it started in 2012, but it was recently on the news again. As Malaysia has renewed their temporary license for another 6 months, and I'm very honored to have invited two wonderful guests on our talk show. So, we have Ewan, an ex-employee from Lynas Corporation.
Hi.
And Jada, an environmental and marketing specialist.
Hi there. Thank you for inviting me.
Welcome to my talk show. First off, let's give a little bit of background on Lynas, shall we? So, Ewan, may I ask, who is Lynas?
Lynas Corporation is an Australian rare earth mining company listed on the Australian Securities Exchange. It has two major operations, a mining and a concentration plant at Mount Weld, Western Australia, and a refining facility called the Lynas Advanced Material Plant in Gebang, Kuantan, Malaysia.
Okay, may we know, what is rare earth?
Rare earth is just a metal as ordinary as other metals like iron, silver and gold. The difference between them is that we don't encounter rare earth in daily life. It's precious, valuable and essential for many high-tech industries. So the size of a single grain of powder can be 100 times smaller than the diameter of a strand of hair.
Alright, thank you Ewan. Now, let's move on the issue of Lynas. The following question are directed to you, Jada. You are the expert in the field of environment. So, what actually do we get from Lynas?
In my opinion, this statement of jobs created, new technology and sales revenue of chemicals, water and natural gas can be ignored actually. Because strictly speaking, in the first 12 years, we got nothing except for large quantities of waste. So to be more precise, 500 cubic meters per hour of wastewater, 100,000 cubic meters per hour of waste gas, and around 280,000 of tons per year of solid waste is what we're actually getting.
What about rare earth? Is it dangerous?
Well, most rare earth metals are harmless actually, but in natural, all rare earth is normally mixed with the radioactive substances, and during the separation process, valuable rare earth is extracted and exported to the US, Europe and Japan, and it leaves behind harmful substances in Kuantan.
Now moving on, we should talk about the solution towards this issue. From a marketing perspective, how do we solve the issue? Give us your insight on this, Jada.
Okay, in my opinion, there is already a ready-made solution, which is the formation of the anti-Lynas group, which is called Save Malaysia, Stop Lynas, SMSL. Yeah. So to build on that given platform, the simplest and most effective way, in my opinion, to solve this issue by marketing is that the anti-Lynas group create a permanent campaign, a strong one, which stands against this lasting issue. So this campaign may include a whole range of strategies which such as social media marketing, email marketing, and employing industry influencers, which all of these are possible to be done free of charge. And it should be appealing to the public audience to attract their attention and actually, you know, generate call to action among the local community. And in fact, social media marketing can provide information to the younger generation and furthermore, motivate and influence them on their perspective on this matter of Lynas being in Malaysia so that they know more about it. And email marketing is free of charge, data can just be gathered anytime, anywhere, and emails with information or even petition letters can be sent out to the community. And last but not least, employing industry influencers can actually help to redirect the public's view on this issue and possibly lead the community to act on it.
Okay, Ewan, what do you think?
From what I think, on top of that, if this campaign is done successfully, it will be able to create an astounding effect on the government and Lynas Corporation. It will affect their work rate and their future planning, since there is such a great external impact from the public. So yeah, I would agree that having a campaign will help to solve this issue.
Okay, thank you for sharing. On top of that, may you also explain what are the marketing theories or models used to form those solutions?
Looking at the ecology and social marketing models, I would say that there are two theories which are related to the marketing solution that I've stated. One of them would be the social marketing theory, because it is an approach used to develop activities aimed at changing or maintaining people's behavior for the benefit of individuals and society as a whole. And the goal of social marketing is always to change or maintain how people behave, but not what they think or how aware they are about on an issue. Yeah, so through this theory, it is shown that the public's behavior has to be changed and that they should actually do something to solve this issue.
Okay, what about the other theory?
The other theory would be societal marketing, which is based on the principle of societal welfare. It emphasizes that an organization must make, you know, like strategic marketing decisions, keeping in mind the consumer's wants, the organizational needs, and most importantly, the long-term interests of the society. So from here, we can actually see that the anti-Lynas group has to craft the campaign in a way that really suits the public audience, and at the same time ensure that it really does not sway away from the initial core objective and will be able to, you know, survive in the long run.
Wow, thank you so much for this wonderful insight from both of you. And so this is the end of the vlog. See you guys in the next vlog. Bye bye.